Whatever problem we are facing, God must provide solution unto it. Therefore, we need to grow. Why are we having all these delays? How come all these things are not going smoothly? Truly, Christians must have a problem, but not to overwhelm us. If we worship diligently and we grow in Christ, I'm telling you, none of us will be able to pay our tithes every Sunday. And that is why we say we need to grow in Christ and total submission to God. Some of us students, we are still going to school. But you see, the way God does it, so you can even get a job aside your schooling that will not affect your education. Some of us, as I said, we already retired. God can provide us with another job to help us with our social security. So, let us grow. Before I travel to Nigeria, we are going to the first testament. This is just a boy came to me outside that he wants to be like a shepherd. Because shepherd always says, anytime he pray for something, he always hear it. But shepherd is a human being like us. Apologies. He's a human being like us, but he developed spiritually. I believe we can do it. All of us can do that. That anytime we need anything from God, if we grow up to that level, we need to grow up to that level so that God will answer us without any delay. And by the grace of God, God will answer us without any delay.
Amen.
Are we ready to grow?
Yes.
Are we ready to grow?
Yes.
That yes is too small. Are we ready to grow?
Yes.
All right. Let us go into our Bible. Abraham had a total submission, grow with God, and total submission with God. And God blessed him abundantly. Solomon and David, you see how God performed miracles in their life. How about Anna and many others? Praise the Lord. We can do better than that. We can do better than that. One thing I like about Celestia is this. We have rules and tenets. I learned to follow the rules strictly. We will grow above our level, and God will give us the ability to grow above our level.
Amen.
First and foremost, how can we grow with God? How can we grow with Christ? First, we need to obey his commandment and do his wish. If you look at our first verse, he said,
then Solomon stood before the altar of the Lord,
yeah,
in the presence of all the assembly of Israel, and spread out his hands toward the heaven. And he said, Lord God of Israel, there is no God in heaven above or on earth below like you, who keep your covenant and mercy with your servants, who walk before you with all their heart. You have kept what you promised.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is what we are saying. You know how big God is. If he has to come to this earth, the earth is not big enough to accommodate him. And if he has to stay in the heaven, it's not even big enough to to accommodate him. But guess what? The fourth chamber of our heart can easily accommodate him. See how big the heart is. And look at the shape of our heart. See how big the heaven is. And God is able to dwell in our little hearts. God is great all the time. Brother and Lord, let us try as much as possible to grow. We are all Christians. Some of us here, we come to church every Sunday. Some of us here, we put on our full regalia every Sunday. But guess what? This does not qualify us to be a Christian. Your heart, what you are doing underneath your roof, your relationship, your wish for others, that one is very, very important if you want to grow with God. I remember the doctor says, stay away from strong alcohol because it's antagonistic to the Holy Spirit. But brother and Lord, we still see some of us in our house, first bottle, second bottle, third bottle. This will take up. Even you think it's not worth your bound. But once the Holy Spirit doesn't want it, don't let us. Please, don't let us do that. Let us grow. How can we grow? We can grow with God by total submission. Let God come and dwell in your heart. Do His wish. Don't let anything betray or take God's request from you. And be a clear-minded person. All this, what I'm mentioning now, they are all prerequisites. It's a license that we must do if we want to grow. We'll be coming to church. This is almost 46 Sunday in 2016. Some of us doesn't even miss it. Some of us don't even miss it. But how come we are still lacking? How come many things are still lacking in our life? Brother and the Lord, let us grow. Who's ever asked to this first lesson? Let's go.
As Solomon.
Yeah.
Stood before the altar of the Lord.
Yeah.
In the presence of all the congregation of Israel, and spread forth his hands towards heaven. And he said, Lord, God of Israel, there is no God like thee in heaven above or on the heavenly, who kept covenant and mercy with thy servants that walk before thee with all their heart, who has kept with thy servants David,
my can you read the other? Go back again. Okay. Who kept?
Okay, from 23.
Yeah.
And he said, Lord, God of Israel, there is no God like thee in heaven above, or on happiness, who kept covenant and mercy with thy servant that walk before thee with all their heart.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What that verse is telling us is that if we grow with God, if we serve Him diligently, and we go in total submission with Him, all His covenant, which he promised us. Solomon in Joseph, it is our turn, it is our time now. The covenant of God must be fulfilled in our life, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So, if we grow, we submit ourselves completely to God Almighty, his covenant will definitely fulfill in our life.
Amen.
Let's continue.
Who hath cared, will return and tell me, my father, that thou promisest me, thou speakest also with thy mouth, and hast fulfilled it with thy hand, as it is this day. Therefore now, Lord God of Israel, keep with thy servant David, my father, that thou promisest him, saying, there shall not fail thee a man in my sight to sit on the throne of Israel, so that thy children take heed to their way, that they walk before me as thou hast walked before me. And now, O God of Israel, let thy word, I pray thee, be verified, with thou speakest unto thy servant David.
Hallelujah. Verse 27. He said, but will God really dwell on earth? The heaven, even the highest heaven, cannot contain you. I mentioned this one. How much less this temple I have built? That was David, Solomon. Yet, give attention to your servant's prayer and his plan. And his plea for mercy. Lord my God, hear thy cry and thy prayer that your servant is praying in your presence these days. May your eyes be open towards this temple. What I'm trying to say here is that without building the temple, our heart is our temple. First, let us allow God to dwell in our hearts. If the heart is heavy, it's not going to accommodate God. If the heart is of evil thought, God is not going to dwell there. If the heart is thinking bad about your neighbor, God is not going to dwell there. Then, how are we going to grow? Now, if we can clear our hearts completely and allow God to dwell there, all our prayers will be answered. But the job now is, how are you going to do it? God will not come down and do it for you. It is you who has to do it. Clear the pathway, allow God to come and dwell in you, and take God completely. When you take God completely, let me tell you the advantage. It's straight by battle. Once you take God completely in your mind, in your heart, sickness will go away. Barrenness will go away. Joblessness will go away. There will be no sorrow. There will be peace of mind. Because God dwells in your heart. Now, it is even very easy. Once it dwells in your heart, it's very easy to ask and receive. Because you can communicate your heart easily. God is here. God, I want this. God will do it for you if you allow him to dwell there. So he's going to give you richness. He's going to give you sound health. He's going to bless you abundantly. Therefore, brethren in the Lord, without wasting time, let us allow God to dwell in our hearts.
Psalm 24, verse 3. Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord?
Yeah.
Or who shall stand in his holy place?
Clean heart.
He that hath clean hands and a pure heart, who hath not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully, he shall receive the blessing from the Lord, and righteousness from God of his salvation.
The Bible says, who, for you, for God to dwell in you, your hand must be clean, your heart must be clean. Not from the soil of the charcoal, nor from the soil of feces. When we're talking about clean hand and clean heart, we all know it. We all know it. Brethren of the Lord, you come in here every Sunday and you go back home, you still thinking about those things Good Shepherd said in January that you should not do. It's still coming to your mind. Adultery, fornication, backbiting, lie, and all those things. Since January up to October, see how long this one is. When and when are you going to cut all this thing off? When and when do you want to grow? When and when do you want to live a happy life? I told you, if you allow God to dwell in your heart, you will have absolute